Now, for years, TVs like this were what everybody had. They might be bigger, they might be console models, you know, 25 inch sitting on the floor. They might be smaller, like this. But they all had dials. And for those of you under 30, if you've ever heard the phrase, don't touch that dial, but have never seen a TV with dials, actual dials, here you go. And as opposed to cable, we had antennas. The rabbit ears, which I have lowered here, were for the VHF channels. That hoop back there was to pull in the UHF channels. And they were still doing dial TVs back in 84, because that's when I bought this Gold Star. And it was one of the first TVs to come over here from Korea and did, you know, an excellent job. The only thing that went wrong with it was it would get a little bluish-greenish spot up in the corner. But if I hooked up a real good antenna and the analog converter to it, it would still work. And maybe I'll do that in another video. But anyway, let me zoom in now and I'll show you what the channels were back in the days of yore, when DeSotos, Pontiacs, Mercurys, and AMC Ramblers roamed the earth. Alright, let's run through the old analog broadcast channels. This was channel 2. That was WBBM, the local CBS affiliate. This was WMAQ, the local NBC affiliate, channel 5. This was, first it was WBKB, then it was WLS, but it was channel 7, the local ABC affiliate, Eyewitness News. Fahey Flynn, Joel Daly, Bill Frink, and John Coleman. And for years, Channel 7 Eyewitness News was the number one news program in the Chicago area at 10 o'clock. All right. Oh, almost forgot. And Channel 7 was where the Bugs Bunny show always was. So, you know, this was where my channel changer was on Saturday mornings. All right. Channel 9, Chicago's very own TV superstation, WGN. The call letters stood for World's Greatest Newspaper, the tagline of the Tribune, who owned it. And this was where you saw Ray Rayner, Bozo Circus, Garfield Goose, Family Classics, and back in the 60s when I was growing up, they were the home of the Cubbies, with Jack Brickhouse. Back, back, back. Hey, hey! Attaboy, Ernie! Woo! Golden days. Golden days. That was how I spent my summers after coming home from day camp in the afternoon, watching the Cubs in good old black and white. And I think this channel was where they had reruns of Superman. All right, for a refreshing change of pace, channel 11 was WTDW. That was our PBS affiliate. And this was where I learned about French cooking from Julia Child and gardening from Crockett's Victory Garden. This old house, Monty Python's Flying Circus at 10:30 Sunday night. And then at 11, they always had the old 50s British movies, usually the Ealing comedies like Genevieve and Tight Little Island and I'm All Right Jack and the Titfield Thunderbolt. So that was my induction into that culture. And then It went all the way over to, whoop, you. And at you, you had to go down to the UHF stations. All right, let's see, what was the first one? Yeah, Channel 20. Our other PBS educational station. And you could take telecourses. The big one I remember is Destinos, which was the Spanish language course. And of course now, they run a lot of the same things that Channel 11 runs. You know, usually quite a bit after the fact. You know, after they run on Channel 11, they run on Channel 20. So I try to support them both. And let's see, let's go to channel 26. I can't remember if that was a Spanish language station or just, you know, regular UHF station that did a lot of, I'm not sure if they had Svengoolie, but, you know, it was that kind of thing, you know, where in the daytime it was trashy talk shows and at night, it was, you know, just reruns of sitcoms. All right, now we get to the big dog. Channel 32, WFLD. Oh, I almost forgot. Channel 26 was WCIU. Now they just call it the U. But anyway, now we're at Channel 32. And back in the day, that was where you saw Bill Jackson and Dirty Dragon. Fie! Now, don't be fying all over my mail. And in 68, Dirty Dragon ran for president. And he probably would have made a better one than the one that we got, Tricky Dick. And they did a lot of reruns, Tom and Jerry, that kind of thing. When Fox bought them, and they became, you know, the local Fox affiliate, cable kind of leveled the playing field for them because they didn't have to be low power anymore on cable. Everything is high power, you know, great signal. So they could take on the big three networks at their own game, and they've been very successful. They've poached a lot of the big three networks affiliates, and I mean, they've basically become a part of the landscape. All right, now we go to channel 38, and that was the religious station. And I never watched it that much. You know, I'd be turning to something else, and I'd see some preacher walking up and down and screaming, and had no idea what they were screaming about, since God is love. All right, now, channel 44, that was a Spanish language station. Is it WSNS? I can't remember. Then we go to channel 50. And that was another one that was a lot of reruns. A lot of talk shows. Not too much original programming. I think they were, for a while, they were UPN, the United Paramount Network, until they kind of lost out to WGN when they started doing, you know, the WB channel in the evenings, and then it went to the CW, which it is now. Let's see. Then there was, I know there was something between 50 and 60. I think it was 56, and I think that was another PBS channel. I think that was it W? No, 62 was WYIN, I think. But that wasn't PBS. So let's see, 60 was another Spanish language station. Then you had 62. Again, that was, you know, local programming. I think Jerry Bryant was on there, JBTV. He's a local guy. He interviewed a lot of rock stars when they would come through town, and he owns his own studio and does a lot of, you know, recording and video editing, that kind of thing. And he has the kind of voice where he has actually done some announcing That's his voice that you hear if you're a local Chicagoan on Motorsports Unlimited, where he says, "Bye-bye and keep on rockin'." And then the last one was 66, and I think that was the Spanish language station. So, wasn't that many stations, but there was always something to watch. I mean, there was just as much to watch as on the 500 cable channels there are now. So, if you've never seen, like I said, a TV with dials, here you go. This was our TV watching universe back in the 60s and 70s. And early 80s, because we didn't get cable here until 87.